On our first episode of our monthly show, The Bryant Buzz, Hornet News reporter Ariel Kirkley gives us an in-depth look at what students are learning right here in the brand new TV production classes just 9 weeks into the school year.
Plus, Liam Babbitt heads to Hill Farm Elementary to talk to paraprofessional Wendy Garcia about the history of Hispanic Heritage Month.
And Portugal Diaz explores career opportunities at the brand new Saline County Career and Technical Campus that opened to Bryant High School students and others this past August.
All of that coming your way next on our first ever episode of The Bryant Buzz.
Hello everybody, welcome to the Bryant Buzz. I'm Kylie Evans.
And I'm Nevaeh Soup. Last week was the debut of Hornet News Now, our weekly show that we hope to produce consistently next semester.
And now this week, we introduce you to the Bryant Buzz. It's our monthly show geared towards longer form stories happening not only on our campus, but in our district and our community.
Each month we hope to showcase your interests and talents during the Bryant Buzz, while we ourselves are in the scale of broadcast journalism. Kylie, we've already begun to learn a lot this year, wouldn't you agree?
Yes, we have. And while our monthly show will focus on others, we thought it was important on our first episode to dive a little deeper into the transformation that has occurred here at Bryant High School with the creation of the TV program.
With our first story, here's Hornet News reporter Ariel Kirkley.
A process that began back in March when Mr. Westbrook was hired as the television production teacher is beginning to take shape. He and the Bryant administration immediately began purchasing equipment in the spring with a plan to develop the classroom and studio space over the summer.
Just felt like this would be a really good place to start something new. I've been very pleased with the excitement level so far, where I felt like this was going to be a place where people would be excited about a TV program. Also, I just felt really comfortable that the administration was going to give me a chance to kind of do it my way.
While it's nice to have a plan for equipment, the classroom still needed students. Like many on campus, senior Austin Williams just kind of landed in the class.
I actually got thrown in this class. I didn't even know this class existed. I didn't know anything. I actually just kind of ended up in here.
Austin has started to find his niche behind the scenes, filming and editing segments for both the Bryant Buzz and Hornet News Now.
I'm very thankful and very happy that I got in this class because I only have 4 periods of the day, and this is like my class that I'm not just stuck doing the mundane, normal school life. I'm in here acting a part of the team and doing some fun stuff.
The standards and goals have been set high with a quick learning curve for the fundamentals of television students.
First and foremost, I want to see them learn, but I want to see them be efficient and effective in their work. I want to see students collaborating, working together, figuring out how to be a part of a team, how to overcome when things go wrong, and ultimately how to produce a product that the campus and the community can be proud of.
However, this is still a very new program, and Mr. Westbrook admits he personally has a ways to go in this process.
I think the biggest challenge has just been kind of getting our feet on the ground and getting settled. Most of the challenges are internal with me, of just like trying to be patient, trying to remember that we're all learning here, and trying to remember that you all don't have 15 years of experience in the industry like I do. And some of these things that just come naturally to me, I forget that I have to take that slow and to teach that concept.
Part of the process is conventions and competitions for the students that will occur in the spring. Austin and others are looking forward to those days.
This year, I'm definitely most excited about getting into those competitions with other schools and other film classes and seeing if we can make the best news story, I suppose. That sounds really interesting.
For the Bryant Buzz, I'm Ariel Kirkley.
You can also find Ariel co-hosting Hornet News Now. As we mentioned at the beginning of the show, we hope to make the Bryant Buzz about more than just Bryant High School.
Reporters will be traveling to other campuses and community events to bring you news from beyond the high school.
During the last several weeks, many of our campuses participated in Hispanic Heritage Month activities.
In our next story, Hornet News reporter Liam Babbitt heads to Hill Farm Elementary to talk Hispanic Heritage Month.
From September 15th to October 15th, Hispanic Americans celebrate National Hispanic Heritage Month. Cultures ranging from Mexico to Chile are recognized for their contributions to the success of the United States. Recently, Hill Farm Elementary School paid tribute to the month with a commemoration to the students' heritage. Hill Farm paraprofessional Wendy Garcia helps the students celebrate their unique cultures.
It means a lot, especially here at school, because many kids, they feel important. And that not just this month, but I mean when they are able to see something that represents their countries, they feel special. And for me, it's like telling us, okay, you guys, you're important too.
With pandemic limitations that were set in place last year, many were not able to celebrate the way that they once were. But with the vaccine readily available and COVID restrictions loosening, communities are able to gather for festivities. High school student Leia Cotto is one of those who has enjoyed the family time.
We celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month by cooking stuff, having parties, fiestas, doing many other things to celebrate and remember our culture, mostly because in the U.S., Hispanics are a minority, so it's kind of difficult to find people you can celebrate with, so we just do it in family and stay together and celebrate.
At the Bryan School District, 15% of enrolled students are part of the Hispanic and Latinx communities. Their contributions and accomplishments both on and off campus are endless. While we should be appreciative year-round, this month in particular allows for the recognition deserved. For the Bryan Buzz, I'm Liam Babbitt.
Thanks, Liam, for that report. Bryant High School in Saline County have a brand new option for students looking to enter the workforce with high-paying skilled jobs.
This past August, the new Saline County Career Tech campus opened its doors, and high school students from all over the county are taking advantage of the opportunity.
The new campus offers a variety of technical skills that will lead to certifications and ultimately employment for our students.
With a look at just two of the many options available, here's Hornet News reporter Portugal Diaz.
At the Saline County Career Tech Center, students have the chance to explore 10 different career path options. The new state-of-the-art facility features industry-standard welding machinery where students are learning hands-on skills. Junior Wedge Wadley is one of the many Bryan students that attend the welding program.
Ever since I was little, it's been like instilled that welders make a lot of money, but it's more than that. I would like to be able just to create anything. Like, I'd much rather do this than any desk job or anything.
The welding program opens the door to multiple opportunities for our students.
With this, I could get into fabricating and then sculpting if I wanted to, or I could do personal pieces for people. I could weld car parts. So I kind of have a big variety of things if I choose welding. So that seemed like the best bet.
Wedge has already earned an OSHA certification, which will help him find much greater success in his career. Welding instructor Mr. Kite has 35 years of industry experience and feels passionate about all students gaining skills here at the center.
I think the crafts that we offer here, you know, in automotive, construction, manufacturing technology, and, you know, my program, welding, I think every student needs to be exposed to it at least.
Mr. Kite is focused and determined to teach his students all the essentials to welding.
When I put my mind on some job, which is what I'm instilling in my students, it's this craft. This craft is by far one of the most important crafts that anybody can do.
What makes the Saline County campus unique is that it's completely free.
You come to a place like this as a high school student, it's free to you. You're getting something that you normally would have to pay out your pocket for. This is free. So yeah, I think they need to get some of it.
There's so much more ground to cover with other programs. And as we continue to produce the show, I'll be back at the Saline County Career Tech Center. With the Bryant Buzz, I'm Portugal Diaz.
That's a great look at the Career Tech campus. I know we will continue to cover the new facility on future shows.
We plan to end each show with a quick feature on someone who embodies the 212 mentality here at Bryant High School.
212 is the temperature at which water boils, made famous here on campus by Buck James and the football team, who have won 3 consecutive state championships.
With our first 212 report, here's Hornet Media reporter Nick Skybo.
212 is just a number to some. Numbers in a license plate, first 3 numbers in their phone number, even just a lucky number. But to the city of Bryant, 212 is more than just a number. It's a mentality, a culture, a family. Our first 212 spotlight is Swarm sponsor and history teacher, Miss Meyer.
I think it means to be 212 that you're always putting in a little extra effort and a little extra work and going beyond what is required of you to make everything, no matter what you're doing, just that much better.
Ms. Meyer has worked at Bryan for 10 years and has been the teacher sponsor for the school club Swarm for 2 years. Swarm's responsibility including creating new and original themes for the football games, setting up and planning student pep rallies, and promoting school-sanctioned events through social media. This is no easy task, but Ms. Meyer prides herself in the 212 mentality she has taken on.
I think that I show the 212 mentality when it comes to Swarm because we're always trying to put a little extra effort into the details to make it that much more fun for the students and to put that much more effort in the tiny details to celebrate not just our football team but all of our athletes and artists throughout the school.
If you have a strong suggestion for our next 212 Spotlight, make sure to email me and give us a name and reason why they are 212. From the Bryant Buzz, I'm Nick Scavio.
We hope you've enjoyed our first episode of the Bryant Buzz. We will be back with the show in mid-November before Thanksgiving break.
And stay tuned for more information on the next episode of Hornet News Now.
To keep up to date with what is happening with the Hornet Media program, follow us online.
On YouTube at Bryant High School Hornet Media, on Instagram at Hornet News Now, and coming soon, the What's Happening Hornets podcast on Spotify.
Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Nevaeh Sue.
And I'm Kylie Evans. I hope you have a great day.